I want to hear more.
Want to hear more? Heidi and Frank? They're back.
On 95.5 KLOS.
Heidi and Frank show. Let's talk about when people say they would and wouldn't wear a mask. Going to the movies, it was 50-50. So you always put popcorn inside your mask and then just be like a food bag, like on a horse. And somebody said that they were at the movies just back in the day. Saw someone with a hoodie on. A new poll asked people to name the top traits of a modern man.
Like a record that's skipping.
Man is truly comfortable with the current era that we're in. Like, modern man. You stand up against racism and prejudice. Okay, anybody raise your hand to give yourself a score. Do you stand up against racism and prejudice? Eric? Jordan? Okay. All right, me and Johnny, too. I was kidding. I was totally kidding. We all had our hands.
Listen, be honest. You don't have to.
I was joking around.
You'll get some other points down the list, I'm sure.
Well, I got a point for that. We'll circle it. All right, modern men. You don't always feel the need to put on a brave face. Eric, yeah, Eric. Jordan, puts his hand up. Johnny, you feel a need to put on a brave face when times are tough?
Yes, I do.
I do, too.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, the patriarch of the family can't be all. Even if we are going to die. I mean, if the meteor is headed this way, you know, you got to be that looking at the kids and going, hey, it's going to be great.
You're
this
fine.
Is awesome. Seriously, we're going to be fine. It'll miss us.
Well, this is modern man, not modern father. Let's be clear. In every situation, I don't feel a need to put on a brave face.
Like what? Name one where you should break down sobbing as a man.
I think it's okay to cry at the movies or to express frustration in your relationship.
In the movies, it's a dark room and you can cry quietly and no one sees you.
Okay, in a conversation about relationship, to reveal your vulnerabilities and things you need out of the relationship. And if that upsets you, then allow yourself to feel it.
All right, so you're saying when you sit down and have an extended conversation about your relationship with the person that you're with, you are going to cry in front of them.
Sure.
And that's going to help the situation. Great, Eric. You're awesome.
Based on Eric's definition, I'm going to put my hand down.
All right, put your hand down. Thanks to Jordan. All right, I don't get a point for that. Eric has 2 points for being modern man. Who's modern manliest?
So far, it's Eric.
Okay. You'd be fine being a stay-at-home dad. The modern man. Eric?
Absolutely. They did a study of all the humans in America. They did stay-at-home moms, stay-at-home dads, working moms, working dads. And the stay-at-home dad was the happiest of all the groups.
Wow.
Happier than a working man.
Because he realizes he's in on the scam now.
Yeah.
What a gig.
Yeah. No, I think
you guys are
love
clueless.
It. It's impossible. It's a hard, hard job.
Yeah.
But once you get in a flow, I think that it becomes one of the most rewarding experiences of your life.
You gonna cry?
Yes.
Modern man.
And he feels like he can.
I would not be fine. I mean, I could do it, but I wouldn't be fine with it. I think old fashioned, call it what you know, the Mike Dick kid in me.
Oh. Now the truth comes out.
Yeah.
I got a little dick kid in me. And I'm old fashioned in that way where I'd feel almost like a failure. Even I'm not saying if you're a stay-at-home parent that you're a failure. But for me and the guys and being the male mentors in my life, I would be laughed at.
You go out, you hunt and gather.
Yeah.
You're not home.
Well, yeah, I would have to. I'm not.
Just not who you are. That's okay. You don't apologize for
that. I'm not apologizing for it at all.
Okay.
Now, don't get me wrong. I couldn't
cry,
be a
like
stay-at-home
somebody.
Husband. I couldn't do that. But I'd be a stay-at-home dad.
Okay.
See the difference?
You couldn't be a kept man.
Right. I think that I have such a strong work ethic.
You couldn't be a trophy husband.
Right. I have to continue to push a rock up a hill. So if that's my kids, then great. But once they're gone, I'd have to push a new rock up a new hill.
Right. I get that.
Okay. The modern man test. Are you a modern man?
Mm-hmm.
You're openly affectionate. Eric?
Yeah.
Another point for Eric. You're openly affectionate. How do you like that? What do you do?
With my family, or I tell my friends I love them. I hug my friends. I don't shake hands when I see my good friends. I hug them.
Well, I guess I hug my friends too.
Yeah.
I still shake hands with strangers.
Yeah. But I say, I mean, if I'm talking to my best friend Brendan, I'll go, all right, bud, love you.
I don't go quite that far.
I mean, we say I love you at the end of every conversation.
Oh, that's
it's almost at the end of every sentence. It's kind of gross.
Yeah, I do love him. We're best friends.
Are you talking
Jesus
with
Christ and Miriam?
Are you talking about friend with friends? You talking about with your kids? You talking about?
No, just being affectionate, not being weirded out if like somebody comes in for a hug.
I feel like Johnny, that's
you.
You're an affectionate
instigator
guy.
Of a hug. Where it's like, hey, you know, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
Only when I've been drinking. I think that's what it is.
You're almost overly affectionate. It's almost rude.
Yeah.
All right. I'll give myself the I'm openly affectionate.
I would say you are, yeah.
Yeah. Modern man, if you're taking the test so far, I'm 2 for 2. Or 2 out of 4. Eric,
4.
You're 4 out of 4 being modern man. What are you, Jordan?
I kind of raised my hand on the last one, so I'm 2.
Okay, 2. Johnny, what you got?
Yeah, I got 2.
2? And you keep scores at home as well. Okay, modern man, next category is you're great with kids. Modern man's great with kids. Not awkward at all.
Yeah, I've always been good with kids. You should count yourself good with kids, too.
Yeah, kids love me.
Yeah, you've always been great with kids. And ever since I can remember, I've wanted children, and I've just really been drawn to playing with them.
That's so weird to say out loud.
Why? I've always wanted kids.
I've always.
Well, it's not weird for a woman to say that.
Wanted children to play with them.
Yeah, can't a girl say, ever since I was 10, I wanted to be a mommy. Ever since I was 10, I wanted to be a daddy.
Did you have a baby doll?
I mean, I had stuffed animals, yeah.
But a baby doll, one that like Little Miss Wetty Pants.
No, and, because
he's scared of dolls, remember? Don't mention dolls.
And my dad wasn't a modern man. I let my kid play with baby dolls. I don't care. My son, he loves them.
I mean, there's a difference between baby dolls and Barbies. A guy can play with Barbies.
Wait, what?
Huh?
As far as, you know, Barbie and, you know, and like action figures.
Yeah.
All my action figures had, Barbie was a whore. Well, I mean, seriously, she got around. I mean, the only guy she ever really dated for a while was Stretch Armstrong in my world. But, uh-huh. I mean, everybody else, she would plow and leave. And she basically cheated on Stretch the whole time at their ski lodge.
Did her and G.I. Joe ever get together?
Yeah.
When he was on leave?
G.I. Joe did her, Lone Ranger did her, and Tano. That was a three-way. Let's see, who else was in that?
Wow. Probably $6 Million Man.
$6 Million Man, yeah. He had that for a while.
I think she even, didn't she do 69 with Rock'em Sock'em Robot?
No, I didn't have Rock'em Sock'em.
Oh, I thought, maybe that was me.
No, I had that guy who would kick field goals.
Yeah, my brother
hit him in the head and he'd kick the field goal.
Yes!
So,
he
kicked her in the cooter several times. I think that she's like, I'm going to have your baby. He's like, no, you're not.
poor Barbie.
And then she would go back to Stretch.
Poor Barbie. And then she had to say, you know, she fell off a horse or something.
Yeah, she fell off Lone Ranger's horse.
Yeah. Like, why are you so, what's up? What's going on?
She put the hi-ho.
Mm.
So, all right.
Childhood.
Here's another modern man quiz questionnaire for yourself. Are you a modern man? You're a good listener.
What's that? Yes, of course I'm a good listener.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can get that point. Mike?
Women?
No, you're not.
With in general, I'm not a good listener?
No.
No, I'd say no.
Why would you say that?
Well, because I have full-on said blah, 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 blah to you, and then nothing.
Well, you just said blah, blah,
well,
blah.
Well, whatever conversation
that's
I'm having.
That's stupid gibberish.
You
I'm
and
not
I,
even gonna acknowledge you said anything.
You and I are sitting here, and I'll say something. Last night, I was watching Netflix, and I'll explain something.
Just during the show?
No, we're just sitting here during a commercial break. I was saying something.
I got stuff to do. Then, Jesus Christ. Then, I'm not over here just willy-nilly talking about stuff that comes in my head.
And then it's well known.
And then you'll look up 5 minutes later, and you'll look right at me and go, what?
That's because I'm working on stuff.
With me, he will process it during that time. But I know there's a good 30-second gap between the question I ask and the answer I'll get.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that I'm not a good listener. It's you guys are great interrupters.
Oh.
And so I'm doing something, and it doesn't matter what I'm doing. You want to tell your story to me right now, and I'm not going to stop what I'm doing until I'm done what I'm doing to listen to you.
Are you giving yourself a point?
No. All right, maybe I'm not a good listener. No, but if it comes to sit down face to face, one on one, Sammy, you can say I'm a good listener.
Oh, well, sure. Sit down. Yes, you can be sit down face to face.
I can be in a moment.
Yes, but I will say, I handed him an email the other day that I had printed out that he needed to read, and I said, hey, here you go. Could have done it on his own time, whatever. In front of my face, he took it and said, oh, and then threw it in the trash. And I said, you didn't read it. And he was like, I didn't. And then he pulled it back out of the trash. So he already wasn't going to listen to whatever that email said before he even knew what it was.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, not every moment I'm into.
You're a good selective listener. How about that?
Right.
Yeah.
I'm a good editor of ridiculousness.
But before you even know what it's about.
Right. I have a sense. I have radar for
that. No, dumb. But we could get your wife on the phone right now, and I guarantee this has happened a million times. Hey, babe, Saturday, we're going to go over to Christine Carlos's, and we're going to do this, and we're going to be there at 6. That's like a Wednesday. Saturday rolls around. He's screwing around, and she's like, babe, we got to get ready. We're leaving. What?
No, that would imply she's organized. So no, that would never happen in my house. Never, never.
And Frank, I told you we're right. Going to... That happens when a guy is doing something that somebody will tell you about plans that you have and you won't be processing. Always get a response from the guy. Always, always, because we're probably busy. I've done
babe,
that a
I told
times.
You. Babe, well, I said
that's a common
Saturday.
Like a couple's therapy exercise is active listening. So someone says something
you.
And then you actually repeat it back to them. And that way, if it's not exactly what they were saying, then they can know they need to explain further. So don't patronize. I hear you. And I think
that's a therapist.
No. Just repeat what I said back to me. That way I know you heard every single word I said. You can't say you didn't because you repeated it back to me. That's the exercise.
Okay.
Yep. That'd help a lot of couples right now. It would. Sammy, don't you think?
I do. I agree with that.
What did I just say?
That everyone needs to repeat that. That I would need to repeat back to you what you said to me so that you know that I'm listening.
See how that works?
That was nice.
That was hey, guys.
Even though the last thing I said was, Sammy, what do you think?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Oh, well.
Hey, guys, this is a good session. Let's put a pin in it. Next week, we'll circle back.
$200, please.
Yeah, right. Sorry, we're out of time.
Why do you think you don't listen?
Oh, that bitch is crazy. She always agrees with you. Yeah, I want to have a show. You know, like a podcast or something where you have the therapy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is one.
I wonder
like
if people, what the couples therapy is there a podcast out like that?
Yeah, forget what the name of it is, but yeah, you get to listen to people's therapy sessions.
You hear the therapist, then you hear the couple. Mm-hmm. It could also be, you know, a YouTube series as well.
Yeah.
But I want to put the microphones and cameras in the car. It's the ride home therapy series. So after therapy, the ride home. It would just be 30 minutes of silence. Like, I'm not talking.
And
to
then
you.
Wait, you drive in the same car to therapy?
Yeah, of course. Don't you?
I didn't.
Mm. Oh.
Separate cars.
Oh, well, that's even
you're
better.
You're in therapy.
Wow, but you're still living in the same house, but you drive separate cars to therapy?
Yeah, well, it was separate bedrooms as well.
Wow.
But we did not drive to therapy together.
You're already deep in separate bedrooms when you decide to go to therapy. Wow. I mean, that makes sense. I mean, obviously, you need therapy if you're in separate bedrooms.
Yeah. Oh.
But then you could put microphones in both cars because everyone has that conversation out loud for everything they wanted to say in therapy and couldn't. It'd be a fantastic show. I'll work on it. Let's see. Also, the Modern Man quiz. Are you a
Modern Man?
Is that a song, Modern Man?
Who is that?
From the...
Hard to recognize that.
That's a Southern Man.
Southern Man.
Neil Young.
Southern Man.
See, you knew what it was. See? Are you a Modern Man? You're okay discussing your mental health. Are you okay discussing your mental health? Raise your hand.
Mm. Sure, yeah. I think it's important to have those conversations.
I don't think you are.
Of how
I
you're
think
feeling
you get very
right
offended when we talk about your mental health.
What?
I think you get offended when we talk about your mental health.
Because you're bullying me about my mental health.
See?
Not listening.
See?
To his needs.
You don't want to hear that you have mental problems.
And no, I know.
Nobody really does.
I know I have mental problems. I'm absolutely positive.
None of us would be here if we didn't.
I don't need you guys poking little holes in them and then peeing in them.
If we were normal, we'd have other jobs.
I'm perfectly okay discussing my mental health.
Me too.
Because I'm the one who was first to admit the mental problems. It's the people who can't admit their mental problems. Eric has a problem admitting his mental problems. So I say you don't get a point here.
Mm-hmm.
I say I know my flaws and mental problems based on that. And I can go, yeah, I understand that about myself. It sucks. Mm-hmm. Can you do that?
Yes, I'm very self-aware. I'm extremely self-aware.
I don't think so. You wore that hat and that shirt today.
That's true.
It's like you don't think about yourself at all.
Yeah, it's like you're aware of your space, but you're not aware of your looks.
All right, I won't give myself a point.
Oh, man.
I guess you
he
guys
doesn't want you to have
know.
A perfect score.
If you guys would know better, I think that's a question that everybody else should answer for the person.
Like my listening question. Johnny?
He's not listening.
What's going on?
What are you doing over there?
Huh?
What are you doing?
He was on to something else. Don't bother him right now.
What are you writing stuff down? What are you doing?
Writing an email.
To who?
To Ranker.
No. He's voting. Are you voting already on Crossing Streams?
Okay. Crossing Streams coming up next. And we do have that Ranker. Thanks for bringing that up. Let's segue. Ranker on our website, HeidiandFrank.com. Go there and you can do thumbs up, thumbs down. It's active. And we'll see what the top five is going to be this week in the Crossing Streams list. A couple more here in the Modern Man test. If your boss or manager was a woman, would you be totally fine with it?
Yeah, we had a boss for a woman. I think all of us were
Dawn,
fine with it.
Fantastic.
I prefer it.
Yeah, same.
You talk openly about your feelings. Yeah.
Hmm. No. Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
I do.
When your feeling is anger.
Right.
Well, that is a feeling.
I openly let you know that that's what I'm feeling.
Mm-hmm.
And,
he does not ever hide it.
You do your fair share of cleaning. I would not say that about myself.
I bet Eric can't
I don't think
either.
I do a share, but I don't know if I do a fair share.
I don't do a share.
When's the last time you did a load
cleaning?
Of laundry?
No cleaning.
What's the last time you did a load of laundry?
I don't even know how it works. I really don't.
My wife's out of town for the weekend. She went up to see my daughter. And so, yeah, I basically, the house was great. I mean, I cleaned it, everything for her when she got back. But it's like, as she was gone, I realized she's the one who messes up the house. So she's only cleaning up after herself. But then she blames the rest of us because she's cleaning all day. I'm like, wait a second. Because when you weren't here, things kind of maintained good as far as cleanliness and clutter and junk.
Everything was smooth.
Everything was smooth as silk. So what's your score? Final scores? Jordan, what'd you get?
I got 6.
All right, 6. I got 6 too, Jordan.
All right.
Of being a modern man.
I got 8.
8. Oh, the most modern of us all. Johnny, what'd you get? You weren't paying attention.
I got 4.
You got 4? Yeah, if you're, 8 or above on this list, a guy 50 years ago would laugh in your face and put a cigarette out in your latte.
Yeah, but I don't care what that guy thinks.
He's dead.
Yes, he is. He's long dead of cancer.
Yeah.
Okay.
Doesn't matter what he thinks.
Let's get some traffic, and then we'll get some news, and then we'll get to Crossing Streams at 9 o'clock. 818-955-KLOS.